everybody. Welcome back to RC Morty Hobbies. I'm Josh, and let's get into it. Okay, as you can see, I've got my nice brand new Outcast EXB 5th scale large roller. Let's get all these fun things on it. And I went with a Hobby Wings Max 5 combo. So I got the big, obviously there's a Max 4, but that'd be way too big for this. But anyway, so Max 5, you get your big ESC. Big motor, 800 kilovolt motor with, I put dual cooling fans, and I have it controlled through electric switch. So I just hit a button on the radio, which is the radio I'm using here. This radio, I just hit the little, this radio is a little G button. I hit that and it turns it on and off. I got my camera mounted to that. And this radio is actually used for all, right now I have four vehicles that use Spectrum stuff. So it's on this Outcast EXB, and it's on that LOC Super Rock Ray Desert Buggy XL E 2.0, and Creighton 6S. Now I added a cooling fan and a cooling and a heatsink to that. I got heatsinks on three of them. No one, I didn't put a heatsink on that one because there's like almost no room in there, but it runs fine. Anyway. So this is the new EXB. Got it finished. The roller means you install your own electronics. So yeah, Hobby Wing Max 5 ESC motor. The big motor is a 56 millimeter. Came with two different mounts, one for the 56, one for a 47. I'm running a 39 tooth pinion and a 39 tooth spur gear. Pinion is actually a spool gear. But people say they've run them and it runs great. The 39-39 combo seems to be a pretty good choice, especially with this big motor. There is a tiny bit of rubbing from the steering setup, if you can see me. It just touches the motor a little bit. Just minutely, so it's not... The touch is like almost non-existent, so I'm not worried about it. And I ran it for a second, it runs great. Decided to go with these big old Duratrex tires. These are belted tires, they're very nice. Beefy, originally got them to put on this bad boy, but I decided to use the street tires from the Duratrex belted lineup for this, so this looks cooler to me and I like the way it runs. Plus you can make it slap around really easy. Decided to go with these nice big belted tires because the stock tire that came with had flat spots. And my guess is it was sitting in the box for a while and they didn't have enough clearance, so it was just sitting on the tires. Because I don't take it out for its first run just to get it tuned and get the steering lined up. It would have some, it was horrible flat spots. I mean, it was bouncing and shaking, and I'm like, what the hell? But thankfully, I had a set of these still in the packaging. Gonna use them on my other one. I can switch them back and forth. They both fit. I can fit them on the big old. I could put in my big EX. I could put in my big old desert buggy if I wish. I could put in the big old desert buggy if I wish, or this bad boy fits fine. The other one is a it's a fifth scale. Desert brick is a very big fifth scale, and then obviously you have some other ones that are even bigger than that. And with that, you can actually fit a max. Four and a big old 70 mil motor in there. Gonna try it out since there's a lot of parts that came out, motor mounts, things like that. So stay tuned for that, right? That's, I like the way that runs as is. That guy right there, my Creighton 6S, is going to get the new Max 8 G2 ESC and the sensored motor setup. So it's gonna run even better than one does. One's good now, it's gonna run even better then. Oh, yeah. That, I went from a 13-tooth pinion to a 17-tooth pinion, and man, is it fly. It's quick, and I got heatsink and cooling fans on it. Same setup as that, except the heatsink on that one's red, versus this is just black heatsink. It looks good. Everything looks nice. But basically, just wondering what was on the price right now. Yes, I got the batteries plugged in, because I'm about to take this out for a spin. I'm going to try to record it, but it's already... You can look at the window, it's already dark outside, so I'm just showing you guys this right now. Looks cool, I got everything kind of tuned in a bit. I got the shocks adjusted so it was level on the ground, so it supports the weight nicely. So when you're taking turns, you're less likely to Basically, it just keeps it more level. I kind of did that for all of them. I put on level surface, which the floor is level, and I guess I tested with my level, and I just leveled out everything. So side to side, front, back, we're good. Anyway, too, with these Spectrum setups, they're AVC or ACV. I'm sorry, it's like it makes the front. It'll control your steering and your throttle depending on what you're doing. It sounds really cool, and I guess on circuit track racing, it probably works better. Something like on these things, you know, I have different channels being used for turning fans on and off, things like that, lights on and off. It was kind of interfering with stuff. Especially with that guy, I got two servos running the steering, and one of them just would not work. I ended up having to disable it. I just disabled it, and everyone had that on there. I finally figured out how to do it. Kind of a pain in the butt to find it, but you literally have to go to the receiver, hit the button three times, and the fourth one, you hold it, and then you go through here to your binding technique, binding method, and then you just test it. Once it turns on, the receiver will flash red three times, and on solid, it tells you it's off, and that's perfect. If you rebind it without doing that method, it'll turn it back on. Another reason I did it is because when I was running this guy yesterday, every time I took a turn, it would just cut the throttle. I was like, eh, no. Anyway, nice body. The EXBs are all black bodies. There you go. Isn't that cool? Those tires really do set it apart. It's a pity that the stock tires got flat spots. I'm just shaking the crap out of it. I even revved it up holding it, let the tires spin out. Still has some issues. I mean, I'll bet if I just ran it, tires as is, somewhere in a grass field, just throttle the hell out of it, eventually we'll probably take care of it, but brand new, and I don't really care to shake the shit out of it when brand new. You know, things have to be done, but I like these tires way a lot better than the other ones, and they're belted, so you don't have to worry about expansion, so you're really going fast, throttling up. These won't really expand, they'll stay pretty good. That's another reason why I have them on that. And those are so narrow, they don't really do much, so it's perfect. And those do balloon, which is interesting, but they're small, so I'm not too worried about it. It's just for the big ones, a balloon, better chance of blowing them up, but yeah, belted tires, very nice. This is my Armor Outcast EXB 5th scale. It's a beast. I love the tires on it. I chose a 5th scale steering servo. It's a 70 kilograms. Not 70 kilograms, it's 70 something, I don't know, whatever. I think it is kilograms of torque at 8.4, right? Well, this unfortunately only do 7.2, so I don't know. I guess it's something with the hobby wings. They've been out for a while. 7.2, 8.4, like all the Spectrums run 8.4 volts to your servos. This is only 7.2. I mean, it still works perfectly fine. And I know with the new stuff coming out, you know, they came out with the Max 4, like the G2 Max 8 and the new Max 4. I mean, I'm looking forward to getting the G2 Max 8 and the new Max 4 set up with them with this perspective sensor motors. But the Max 5, I'm running a little bit, it's on the motor in there, 800 kilovolts. It's nice. I mean, just the low speeds, it's nice. So high speeds, even better, right? Everything else is pretty much going to stay as well. That's probably going to stay more stocked than the rest because I just like the way it works, runs quick. Yeah. Yeah, that'll get a Max 4 with the. With the 560 kilovolt motor, and it'll be it's a 70 millimeter and do what it takes to make it work. I mean, because I have cooling fans right there, there's a cooling seat sink in the fans. I put an opening right there for that, and not bad. Obviously, when I'm switching this over to a Max 4, I'm gonna end up probably having to remove a little more material just so it has enough room for the cooling fan on for this. ESC, I'm sorry. There is no cooling fan or heat sink set up for a 70mm motor as of yet. So it'll just be as is. And the guy I'm watching, he had set this up, and he actually got a bunch of parts that came out so you can actually fit it in perfectly. And that's the parts I'm going to be getting when I get my Max 4 and the big motor. He's running like a 22. He's running a 22 tooth. I'm probably going to go with a 25 tooth. Because I kind of like a little more speed. We'll see. I don't want overheating. I mean, he's running 22, and it seems to be running fine, because I think if you go too high in those motors, you will get them hot. We'll see. I'm going to get a 25 and a 22 and a 20, just play around, see if it works best. But as a 17 on the particular setup on this now, it's quick. And with the cooling fans on it, keeps it from burning out. Same with this one. Cooling fans, because it does have a 39 tooth pinion, 1-to-1. It will get hot, so cooling fans on it. There you go. I even got a temperature gauge. The problem is you need this $50 piece to plug into the receiver, to plug into that to make so you can actually read temperatures on that. And I haven't gotten that to there yet, so soon enough. Alright, stay tuned. I'll show you more in a bit. Oh yeah, don't forget to subscribe, leave a like, comment. It really helps the channel. I'm trying to get to the point where I'm actually monetized. I need 1,000 subs to do that. And I can start being, you know, part of the ad stuff, make a few bucks. It'd be great to be able to fund the projects and make some more, build some more, do some more. The reason I have these new cars right now, cars and trucks, is because when I sold this big rig build, and you know, there's people those out there who love those things and collect them, and I actually got two people asking me when I got another one built to let them know. I mean, that's great, but it does cost me almost as much as I sell it for. Almost. I did make a little money on it, not much. And then I sold a giant train layout, and that helped fund the rest of these. Basically did it and got me the rest of these. So yeah, very good. And the train layout was a pain in the butt to get shipped because it had to be split in three pieces, put in crates. And I didn't know that a lot of these companies will not take anything more than 8 feet long, and two of the boxes were 9 feet. Next time around, I will be making sure that I'm not building anything more than an 8x4. I'm not going to sell it for as much as what I did sell for, but it'll work. But I knew you have a couple avenues to making money as far as building those Tamiya big rigs, people like buying them off me, and then train layouts, a little more simplistic this time, because it took me about almost a year and a half to build the one and sell the one I had. But yeah, cool stuff, my little room set up here. My wife's planning on building a freaking Murphy bed set up in here. I'm like, oh, great. It's going to take up space. I'm going to lose a table. Unfortunately, it's because we only have 3 bedrooms in this particular house. The other one had like 5. But the location's a whole lot nicer, and the house is nicer, too. So, yeah. It's just, I guess, when her mom comes up to visit. But she's trying to get her family moved up here, so. Lots of stuff. We're actually looking at buying property, some land, like 5 acres, and build a tiny house on it. For her parents to live in, so they can watch the property, and then build a shop for myself. So then basically all the stuff will be in a shop, along with an auto lift, so I can do my own services on my vehicles, which I already do. It's just kind of a pain in the butt being on the ground, even with a pickup truck, even with a roller and all that, still it's pretty close. I don't have it lifted, so. Anyway, stay tuned for more stuff. Thanks for watching, guys.